This video is about the beautiful nature park Mole National Park. If you happen to have the chance to visit Ghana, then you should definitely go and see the animals that live in this beautiful nature park. Okay, let's take a closer look to some of these beautiful animal species that the Mole National Park has. And the first one is the common warthog. They also have hartebeest, the red-throated bee-eater, patas monkeys, palm-nut vultures, Abyssinian rollers, a yellow-backed duiker, a bushbuck, Diffasa waterbuck, African bush elephant, which is the main animal of the park and a definitely must see, olive baboons, shrike, African buffalo, African grey hornbills, martial eagles, and green velvet monkeys. Okay, we're gonna now have a closer look at all of these animals to see what their main features are in Africa. Mole National Park is Ghana's largest wildlife refuge. The park is located in the savanna region of Ghana, on savanna and riparian ecosystems at an elevation of 150 meters, with a sharp escarpment forming the southern boundary of the park. The African bush elephant. The African bush elephant lives across 37 African countries and inhabits forests, grasslands and woodlands, wetlands and agricultural land. The core of the elephant society is the family unit, which comprises several adult cows, their daughters of all ages and their sons of preparable age. Diet mainly consists of mainly grasses, tree barks, papaya, bananas, guava, maize, sorghum, sugarcane. The conservation status of the African bush elephant is considered as vulnerable. Olive baboons. They live in large areas of Africa, basically in a climate zones that are called the Sudanian savanna. The olive baboon lives in groups of up to 50 to 150, made up by few males, many females and their young. Each baboon has a social ranking somewhere in the group depending on its dominance. Female dominance is hereditary, within daughters having nearly the same rank as their mothers. Their diets consist of plants, invertebrates, small mammals, fruits, worms, roots, lichens, mushrooms and scorpions. Their conservation status is considered as least concern. The Diffasa waterbuck. It's a large antelope which is found widely in sub-Saharan Africa. Waterbuck are rarely sedentary in nature, though some migration may occur with the onset of the monsoon. Their diet consists mainly of grass, reeds, small shoots and fruits, and their conservation status is considered to be least concern. The African grey hornbill. It's a widespread and common resident breeder in much of the sub-Saharan Africa and even into Arabia. This bird prefers open woodland and savanna. The female lays 2 to 4 white eggs in tree hollow, which is blocked off during incubation with a cement made of mud, droppings and fruit pulp. The African grey hornbill is an omnivorous animal. It takes insects, fruits and reptiles, and it feeds mainly in trees. Its conservation status is considered to be as of least concern. Abyssinian roller. It's a member of the roller family of birds which breeds across tropical Africa in a belt south of the Sahara known as the Sahel. Its resident is in the southern parts of the range, but northern breeding populations are short migrants moving further south after the wet season. These rollers often perch predominantly on trees, posts, or overhead wires like giant shrikes whilst watching for the large insects and small rodents on which they feed. They will dash into the smoke of a forest fire for disturbed invertebrates. They are fearless and they will dive and roll at humans and other intruders. Their conservation status is considered to be as of least concern. Yellow-backed duiker are the most widely distributed of all duikers. They are found mainly in Central and Western Africa, ranging from Senegal to the Western Uganda, with a possible of a few in Gambia. Their range also extends southward in Rwanda, Burundi, Zaire, and most of Zambia. Yellow-black-backed duikers are mainly forest-dwelling and live in semi-deciduous forests, rainforests, riparian forests, and montane forests. However, they can be found in open bush, isolated forest islands and clearings on the savannas as well. Their conservation status is nearly threatened. The bush buck. As it is commonly known with its range, it's a widespread species of antelope in sub-Saharan Africa. The bush buck are found in rainforests, montane forests, forest savanna, savanna bush and woodland. And their conservation stage, their diet consists of plants, leaves, roots, shoots and grass, and their conservation status is considered as least concern. Hartebeest. Inhabiting dry savannas and wooded grasslands, hartebeests often move to more arid places after rainfall. It's an African antelope. 8 subspecies have been described. Gregarious. The species forms herds of up to 300 individuals. Larger numbers gather in places with abundant grass. Hartebeests are primarily grazers and their diet consists mostly of grasses. Conservation status is considered to be as of least concern. The African buffalo is one of the most successful grazers in Africa. It lives in swamps and floodplains as well as montane grasslands and the forests of the major mountains of Abrasjeros. The southern buffalo is in morphological terms intermediate between the first two subspecies. It occurs in West Africa. Its dimensions are relatively small, especially compared to the other buffalo. Their diet consists mainly of grasses. Their conservation status is nearly threatened. The red-throated bee-eater. This species is found in tropical Africa. The red-throated bee-eater is a colonial species, nesting in groups and remaining in the nesting area all year round. Its range extending from Senegal and Gambia into the west to Uganda, southern Sudan and Ethiopia. Its typical habitat is savanna with scattered trees, farmlands with trees, the edges of marshes, bush, pastures and gardens, but the birds are seldom to be found far from the erosion gullies and streams and small rivers near their nests. In the banks of which they nest, there are tunnels excavated before the ground dries after the rainy season, the colony having up to about 50 nests. The common warthog. These pigs live in open to semi-open habitats, even in quiet arid regions in sub-Saharan Africa. The common warthog is the only pig species that has adapted to grazing and savanna habits. Its diet is omnivorous, composed of grasses, roots, berries and other fruits, bark, fungi, insects, eggs and carrion. The diet is seasonably variable, depending on the availability of different food items. During the wet seasons, warthogs graze on short perennial grasses. During the dry seasons, they subsist on bulbs, rhizomes and mucus roots. Common warthogs are seasonal breeders and their conservation status is to be of least concern. The palm-nosed vulture. It breeds in forest and savanna across sub-Saharan Africa, usually near water. its range coinciding with that of the oil and raffia palms. It's quite approachable, like many African vultures, and it can be seen near habitation. Unusual for birds of prey, the palm-nut vulture feeds mainly on the fleshy fruit husks of the oil palm and on the palm fruits of the raffia palm. These trees make up over 60% of the adult bird's diet and over 90% of the juvenile bird's diet. It has also been recorded to feed on crabs, mollusks, frogs, fish, locusts, small mammals and even reptiles. Their conservation status is to be as of least concern. The Patas monkeys. It's a ground-dwelling monkey distributed over semi-arid areas of West Africa and into East Africa. The Patas monkey feeds on insects, gum, seeds and tubers. The Patas monkeys live in multi-female groups of up to 60 individuals. Marshalager and the group contains just one adult male for most of the year. Their conservation status is of nearly threatened. Alright, I've created an exercise for you, a game of the wildlife at Mole National Park, and you can play it if you want yourself. It's all for free and fun and education. You can find the link in the description of this video, and I wish you good luck with playing this game and learning about all the animals that live in the beautiful country of Ghana. And everyone should go and take a visit to the Mole National Park. Alright, I'm gonna end this video with some nice pictures of the Mole National Park.